سما قبال العبد إذا ارتنما.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back for another episode of Daily Dose. Inshallah, our theme for today, or the topic of today, is reflection. And again, it is based on the hikam, or the words of wisdom, of Ibn Ata'illah. And today's hikam states that bury yourself in the land of anonymity. A seed that is never buried will never produce. And there is nothing more beneficial to the heart than isolation that allows it to enter a state of reflection.
So Ibn Ata'illah gives this example of the seed. Before it produces and before it grows, it needs to be secluded under the earth where it can have a firm foundation where it extends its roots.
And the same can be said for a child when it is in the womb of the mother, that it has to stay in that period of 9 months where it gets strong. Again, it's developing itself, it's becoming firm so that it will be able to last and to be able to sustain itself in this world.
The same applies to our hearts. In order for the heart to be alive, it needs to be in seclusion with its maker.
Now, to clarify, when we talk about seclusion with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are not talking about monasticism or monkhood where we stay in a monastery all day. We are talking about living amongst the people and enjoying good and forbidding evil, but at the same time taking a part of our day, you know, a certain time where we seclude ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so we can reflect on His creation.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about this concept in the Quran. He says in Surah Ali Imran, chapter number 3, verse 190, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب.
Indeed, in the creation of the heavens and earth, and in the alteration of night and day, are signs for those of understanding. And isolation or reflection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam practiced himself. We all know that he used to spend time in the cave of Hira before prophethood and after prophethood, and he would spend hours and days and sometimes weeks in the cave with, you know, very little food, and he would reflect on the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in addition, even after prophethood during the month of Ramadan, he would always spend the last 10 days in i'tikaf, just as we do in, you know, many masajid around the country. And in the last year of his life, the last Ramadan of his life, he actually spent the last 20 days in i'tikaf in the masjid. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the best of examples, and he lived amongst the people and he would be of service to the people, but at the same time, when he had free time, when he had a few moments, he would use that time to reflect on the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمن الذي يخالط الناس ويصبر على أذاهم خير ممن لا يخالط الناس ولا يصبر على أذاهم.
And in a hadith that can be found in Ibn Majah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the believer who keeps the company of people and is steadfastly patient over their harm is better than the believer who does not keep the company of people, nor is he steadfastly patient over their harm.
So we befriend people, we go to school, we marry, we forbid evil, we enjoy that is good, we visit neighbors and relatives, but at the same time we still find seclusion and we still turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in reflection.
So as we continue on our journey to God, as we continue on the journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to remember that we also need to focus on our heart. That sometimes we focus on salah and we focus on, you know, giving charity and fasting, which all things are physical. Physical things in physical forms of ibadah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we also need to reflect and we need to seclude ourselves and we need to think about the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so it can have an effect on our hearts. And inshallah, if we can do that, then we will not be from the people who have hard hearts.
So to help you get through Ramadan each and every day, check out the Master Arizona page to get your Daily Dose.
Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to another episode of Daily Dose. Our topic for tonight is going to be...
You smell it?
Oh my god!